Isabelle Everett with a national news briefing. Victoria's driving towards its 70% fully vaccinated milestone to reopen, announcing new pop-up sites at cafes, gyms and shopping centres. Health Minister Martin Foley says the state now sits at 60.9% double doses.
Over the coming weeks, we will be rolling out a local neighbourhood pop-up vaccine program, which means Victorians will be able to get vaccinated in an increasingly vast array of places, be they gyms, be they local clubs, shopping strips.
Comes as the state recorded 1,571 local COVID cases overnight and 13 further deaths, while the Mitchell Shire will come out of lockdown at midnight. The Northern Territory has introduced one of the strictest vaccine mandates in the world. Workers who interact with the public have until November 13 to get their first jab, and if they don't comply, they could be hit with a $5,000 fine. Two states have made major climate announcements today as calls continue for the PM to commit to more ambitious targets. Tasmania has announced new laws to make net zero emissions by 2030 mandatory for the state, while New South Wales has unveiled a new hydrogen plan to transition away from coal and halve emissions by 2030.
Today's announcement will see New South Wales become the renewable energy superpower of the planet, providing not only our energy needs, but the rest of the world's energy needs as well, and make a lot of money doing so.
The state's Environment Minister, Matt Keane, there.
Open your ears to a new world of audio, radio, podcasts, music and news. Catch Carrie and Tommy and much more on Listener. Download the new app and listen for free.
It looks like the Bobby Hill trade will go down to the wire. Essendon is keen, but GWS are holding firm. Adelaide has finally secured Jordan Dawson via a trade with Sydney, and Geelong still going back and forth with Fremantle as Jordan Clarke eyes a move home to WA. The trade deadline is tonight. And Socceroos coach Graham Arnold is calling on the New South Wales government to allow a full house into their World Cup qualifier against Saudi Arabia next month. Fresh off a 2-1 loss to Japan, Arnold believes the Japanese fans had a big influence on the result.
Selling the family home, Miller, Juan and John put you first.
This is SAFM weather.
A possible thunderstorm on the Limestone coast this evening as we drop to 9 degrees overnight. Tomorrow, showers and 16 again, and Friday, more showers, 15. For radio podcasts, music and news, download the free Listener app.